Hey guys, in this video, we're going to talk about how to keep a woman happy in a relationship, especially if you need to rekindle passion. So even if you're not in a relationship, this is a great video to watch because you'll want to know how to prevent her from losing attraction to you. So if you're new to my channel, my name is Anna Jorgensen. I'm a dating coach for men. Welcome to Just the Tip Tuesday. So reality land is that healthy, satisfying relationships, they take work. They're not just reliant on love. Love is not enough. Love is the answer, but it's not enough to sustain a relationship, especially long term. If you're watching this, you probably know that. And you probably know that after a long time together, that things can become a bit stale. And most of the time, women feel this sooner than men and often end up cheating or leaving. So if you want to prevent that from happening, then you need to do a few things. And here's some of the things that you can do to help prevent her from becoming unhappy. And they'll make you happy too, like bonus win-win situation here. Because men are hunters, right? So you're the hunter, you chase the game or you pursue the game. And then once you catch your prey, so to speak, you sort of relax. And what that looks like in a relationship is taking us for granted. So then the woman starts to slack in the areas that are important to you, and then nobody's happy. So that's not the way to have a relationship. Well, not a good one anyway. So what can you do? First of all, you have to realize and accept, not even just accept, you have to embrace the fact that women typically tend to need higher amounts of emotional, intellectual or mental, and physical stimulation to be able to continue to be attracted to you in a relationship. Men need these things too. Well, men desire and appreciate these things too, but you can actually just get turned on by the physical, whereas women really need all of it in order to get to that place. So if you want to keep her happy, and especially if you want to be able to keep passion alive in your intimate relationship, then you're going to need to pay attention. Because while women are also responsible for making sure they keep up their end of the bargain, you have no control over what she's doing. You only have control over what you're doing. So if you want to take responsibility for your part, then you'll have more of a ripple effect in the relationship that will be a positive outcome for both of you. You'll get more of your needs met, and she'll be happy in providing those needs for you. Let's get right into it. Number one, communication. You hear about this all the time, but the reality is, especially when you are in an intimate relationship, and especially if you need to rekindle the passion in an intimate relationship, the sooner you start communicating about your intimate physical part of your relationship in the relationship, the more easy it will be to continue that communication when it actually requires it. So if you never talk about it, and then things are starting to go sideways, it's going to be way more awkward to bring up what's lacking if you don't have a strong communication between you from the very beginning. So work on communication. If you're already further down the road, you're going to have to actually get out of your comfort zone and start feeling and being a little bit more vulnerable by addressing it, talking to your woman about the things that are lacking anywhere in your life, but you'll have to be subtle about it. And yeah, you're going to have to be super brave because it's so much more difficult to do this if it's been a while. So the sooner you can get on a good track of open communication, even when you don't think you really need to, do some check-ins, it's going to help you out a lot more when you actually do need to address certain things. Okay, so that was kind of a long-winded number one. Anyways, number two. So mood, setting a mood. Women, well, everybody really, but especially women, tend to wane in their physical needs as they get older, or sometimes after they've had kids. It's a harsh reality, but it is a reality. And if you want to be in a long-term relationship, this is something you're going to eventually face, so you might as well deal with it. This means that sometimes spontaneity isn't going to be as practical. So you may have to actually schedule the date night or the romantic evening or the road trip or the afternoon or whatever it is. You may not be able to be as spontaneous as you would have liked to have been. But if you can start again planning this earlier in your relationship, especially in the early days, you know, it's easy to be spontaneous when you're just first, you know, into someone, but later on, things can become more habitual and boring. So it's okay to schedule intimate time and romantic time with your partner. In fact, it's really important to do that. And if you want to know what to do, then you can go back to number one and communicate with her about what works for her. So you don't have to guess. You can ask her. You can ask her what will get her in the mood to spend quality, intimate time with you. As well, you have to remember that, again, women require more stimulation to be able to get to the point of wanting physical intimacy or romantic intimacy. So it's, well, you can actually become ready without having to go through a whole process. Physical touch is often enough for men if it's a necessary need at the moment. Women do need other types of stimulation and extra physical stimulation. So I think you probably know that, but just in case. Good little reminder there. All right, next. Okay, number four. Women need intimacy. Now, intimacy isn't just about physical contact. Intimacy is about emotional connection. It's about feeling understood. It's about being seen, feeling heard, basically validation. And women do need this a little bit differently than men. I go into a lot more detail in my Wake Up to Love program. So if you haven't taken that, I definitely recommend it, obviously. And it'll help you through that quite a bit more. But essentially, women need to feel intimate, emotionally connected, before they can feel intimate, physically connected. And one little way of doing this is being able to share your thoughts and feelings about things that are going on in your world, and as well as what's happening in her world, and listening without trying to fix. I did a video on that as well. Some guys feel like if they show too much or any vulnerability, that's going to be a turnoff, which is to a degree true because women go into mothering mode when you're being vulnerable. But there is a way around that. I've done a video on how to balance alpha masculinity with vulnerability. So you definitely want to check that out. I'll put a link below. Okay. Next one. This is the one you're probably going to appreciate because it speaks to your engineer's mind. Technique. So yes, this is what we're actually talking about, the specifics of what to do. So this might be specifically on how to take out the garbage that she appreciates that will put her in a mood to want to reciprocate being loving towards you, all the way to the other end of the scale where it might be specific techniques on what pleases her in the bedroom. So you need to be able to ask and get past your ego to really know what turns her on. Five, variety. So yes, variety is the spice of life. And this isn't just in the bedroom, this is in life. So again, if you're just doing the same old, day in and day out, she's going to get bored. Even if she can't express that, she may not be able to actually ask her for that. She'll just get moody or cranky and not realize what she's actually needing. So it's, again, your job, and she has many jobs in the relationship as well, but right now you can only do what you can do. So I'm trying to help you here. So your job is to try and create some variety so that things aren't always the same old, same old. So you're going to need to be creative. And how to do that? You're going to refer back to number one, communication. Talk to her. Number two, intimacy and sharing feelings. And number three, technique. Number six is really important. It is about romance. And romance isn't just about chocolates and flowers and a nice dinner. It's about understanding and expressing love to your partner in their love language. So I've done a video on what the five love languages are. You can watch that. It's really great. That's really how you build up points with your partner, is by expressing love in the way they like to receive it. Okay, number seven. This will happen over time, no matter how long you're in a relationship, but it's really important to actually pay attention to this right from the beginning and then continue paying attention to this within your relationship. Women are insecure about their bodies. Some of us say we're not, but we tend to be insecure at the beginning of a relationship when you haven't seen us and we're not sure if you'll like what the package is under the packaging. But we also are or can become insecure about our bodies as we age because, one, we're aging, two, our bodies might have changed due to aging or childbirth and things like that. So it's really important for you to understand and appreciate your woman's body and to compliment her on it. So don't take it for granted that she's just going to assume that you like her body because you can get aroused by it, she needs to hear the words out of your mouth that you appreciate all her bits and parts. And the more specific you can be, the more appreciated, the more effective that kind of compliment will be to a woman. And again, if you're not sure what is going to make her feel best or most comfortable or what would be the most effective words to say, you can try out a few and see how the reaction is, or you can go back to number one and communicate and ask her. Number eight, sensuality. Women love sensuality. It allows us to get into our feminine. When we're in our feminine, we are able and wanting to receive from you the physical intimacy that you want to provide for us and allows us to provide for you. So what does sensuality mean? It doesn't mean S-E-X. It actually revolves around all the senses. Sensuality, senses. So what can you do with the senses? First of all, sight. This would look like the ambiance of the room or the restaurant that you choose to take her to or anything that's visual that will make her feel relaxed and ready. The next part of sensuality is smell. So again, this could mean scented candles. It could mean wearing her favorite cologne. It could mean scented flowers or, well, not all flowers are scented. It could mean her favorite flowers that are scented. It could mean anything that has to do with smell. It could mean a freaking chocolate fondue. I'll tell you what, that'll do it. Okay, anyway, next. Okay, also part of sensuality is touch. And this is not just about sex. This is about how to keep her happy overall in general in life. So touch can mean holding her hand or rubbing her back or just a tender squeeze of her arm to let her know that she means something to you. Now that's in the general day-to-day, but it can go all the way up to the other end, which might be maybe a sensual massage. So you're not just going for the goods right away. Okay, taste. Tasty. Taste can be, well, the best taste is really kissing because, you know, if you're already together, you're already attracted to each other, you know that you like your pheromones. And part of that is in sharing spit. So that's one of the best aphrodisiacs, but it can also include on the day-to-day different things that are pleasurable for her. Maybe she loves a T-bone steak. Hello, that'll do it for me. Or maybe she's really loves chocolate or good quality chocolate or whatever it might be that will keep her happy. Sound, soft music, spa music. This is again, not just in the moment, but also the weight and tone of your voice, how caring you are in the way you're communicating with her with your voice. And yes, all the way to sexy time music when you're in the mood for the sexy time. And actually on this note, one of the most important sounds that she cannot hear if you're actually going for the full meal deal at the end is the kids. She will go straight into mother mode if she's worried about hearing the kids or having to be on alert for them. Number nine, passion. So passion isn't just about what you do in the bedroom. It's about passion for life. It's about passion for something that you're really interested in? Something you're really interested in, as long as it's not something she's competing for or competing with for your attention. So if you are into gaming, but it takes time away from her and she's always nagging about you, well, that's not a passion that's actually going to get her motor running. But if you are into building motorcycle or whatever it is that you might be into that doesn't take away from her, she appreciates knowing that you have something that's autonomous. And as well, passion also includes being excited for her about the things that she's excited about in life, so that when you can listen to her talk about some of the things that are her passions, then she feels seen, validated, understood, and that appeals to the intimacy portion of what she needs in the relationship. Okay, and number 10, pleasure. So what I mean by this is women are far more able to give and receive pleasure when their needs are met. Their general needs in life, not just in the bedroom. So what this looks like is when she asks you to help out with some chores, that you do them in a timely fashion, not begrudgingly. If she asks you to help out with the kids or whatever it is that will help relieve her from stress mode, will help her relax into receiving mode and therefore giving mode in all areas of the relationship. And of course, like I said, there are lots of things that she can do to help her self get back into her body and out of her head so that she can be more ready, willing, and interested in the intimate parts of your relationship, whether they're emotional, intellectual, or physical. So you do what you can do, and if you do pay attention to these 10 things, then the ripple effect should be that she will start to reciprocate as well. And at some point, you can even ask for what you need. It's good to ask for what you need. Yes, it's very good. Very good indeed.